Hello. In the previous session of Digital Signal Processing online lecture series, we have completed the unit structures of filters. In that, we have seen two types of filters, FIR filters and IIR filters. We have seen the examples of obtaining structures for these two filters. Now, in this session, we are going to start the new unit, which is Discrete Fourier Transform, that is DFT. We will see its properties and application in this chapter. So, let's start with the basic introduction of DFT. So, first of all, let us see what is discrete Fourier transform, what is the definition of it. Now, it is a finite duration discrete frequency sequence which is obtained by sampling one period of Fourier transform. So, sampling is done at n equally spaced points over the period which is extending from omega equals to 0 to omega equals to 2 pi. So, whenever the sampling is done at every fixed instance, that will be called as discrete Fourier transform. Let us see how it is mathematically represented. So, by using the mathematical equations, we will see discrete Fourier transform and the inverse discrete Fourier transform. So, first of all, let us see DFT. So, the DFT of discrete sequence, which is noted as x of n, is given as x of k. So, DFT is noted by x of k. It is mathematically given as x of k, that is equals to summation of n equals to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi k n by n. Here k equals to 0 to n minus 1. Here as n points are taken, this is called as n point DFT. Now same way, if I have the value of x of k and I want to obtain the discrete sequence, that is the original discrete sequence back from its DFT version, that will be called as inverse discrete Fourier transform. So for IDFT, we can obtain x of n from x of k, which is mathematically given as x of n, that is equals to 1 by n, summation of k equals to 0 to n minus 1, x of k into e raised to minus j, 2 pi k n by n. Again, as it is taken for n point, it is called as n point IDFT. Now, throughout this entire chapter, you need to remember these two formulas, which is very important for any example. Which is the first one, that is the definition or mathematical equation for DFT. That means the first one, which is given as x of k, that is equals to summation of n equals to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n by n. Then IDFT formula x of n, that is equals to 1 by n summation of k equals 0 to n minus 1 x of k into e raised to plus j 2 pi k n by n. Now this will be more clear to you when we will see the examples. So let's see one basic example of finding DFT. So here the example is given to you, which is given as obtain the value of x of 4 for 8 point DFT if x of n is 1, minus 1, 0, 2, 1, minus 2, minus 1 and 1. So let's see how we solve this example. So to solve this, let us take the values n and small n. That means over here 8 point DFT is indicated. So you are given n equals to 8. And you need to find x of 4. That means x of k equals to x of 4. You need to take k equals to 4. Alright. Now using the definition, we know that according to the definition of DFT, it is given as x of k, that is equals to summation of n equals to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi k n by n. This is the formula which we are going to use to solve this example. Now here k is the instant at which the value is to be find out, that means k equals to 4. Then n equals to number of point, which is 8 over here. So we will take capital N equals to 8. We will vary the value of n, that means range of n, starting from 0 to 8 minus 1, that means 0 to 7. And we will place the values accordingly in this. So let's start. We need to find x of 4. So we will take k equals to 4. Summation of n equals to 0 to n minus 1, that means 8 minus 1, that is 7, x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi, k value is 4, small n by 8. Okay, so let us continue with this. This will give 2 into 4, 8, that will be cancelled out with the denominator part, which will give here as e raised to minus j n pi, right? So let us put the instants n equals to 0 to 7 in this equation. So when given to us is 1 minus 1 0 2 1 minus 2 minus 1. So if we continue doing the x of 4 value, so for that we have x of 4, that is equals to summation of n equals to 0 to 7 x of n into e raised to minus j n pi. Now we are placing the instants from n equals to 0 to 7 in this equation and then adding them. So first of all, let us take n equals to 0. That will give x of 0 into e raised to 0 plus x of 1 into e raised to minus j pi, because we have taken n equals to 1. Now next n equals to 2, which will give x of 2 into e raised to minus j 2 pi plus x of 3 into e raised to minus j 3 pi plus x of 4 into e raised to minus j 4 pi plus x of 5 into e raised to minus j 5 pi plus x of 6 e raised to minus j 6 pi plus x of 7 e raised to minus j 7 pi. Okay, we have placed the values n equals to 0 to 7 in this instant. Now let us simplify this. So first of all, here it is x of 0. X of 0 means the value of x of n at instant n equals to 0. Here arrow is indicated at n equals to 0, whose value is 1. So we can say that this indicates n equals to 0. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So if you want to write down over here x of 0, that is 1. So here it is 1, e raised to 0 is 1 plus x of 1, x of 1 is minus 1. So it is minus 1. Now the next is e raised to minus j pi. So here to simplify this, we are going to use the standard formula of e raised to minus j theta, which is given as cos theta minus j sin theta. Right? So here it is e raised to minus j pi. That means we will have cos pi minus j sin pi. Right? So cos pi value is minus 1 and sin pi is 0. So here we will have minus 1 plus x of 2. X of 2 given to us is 0. So we will write down over here 0. Plus next is x of 3. X of 3 value is 2. So we will write down over here 2. In the bracket we will have cos 3 pi minus j sin 3 pi. Now cos 3 pi is minus 1 and sin 3 pi is 0. Same way for x of 4, the value is 1. In the bracket we will have cos 4 pi minus j sin 4 pi. Cos 4 pi is 1 and sin 4 pi is 0. Next x of 5. X of 5 is minus 2. In the bracket we will have cos 5 pi minus j sin 5 pi. Cos 5 pi value is minus 1 and sin 5 pi value is 0. Next, we'll have x of 6. X of 6 is minus 1. In the bracket, we'll have cos 6 pi minus j sin 6 pi. Cos 6 pi is 1 and sin 6 pi is 0. And the last instant, we'll have x of 7, that is 1. In the bracket, we'll have minus 1 because we'll have the value cos 7 pi, which is minus 1. Now, let us simplify this. So, we'll have first value 1, then plus 1, plus 0, minus 2, plus 1, plus 2, minus 1, minus 1. So, this will give the final value as 1. So, this is the answer of x of 4. That means at n equals to 4, the value of DFT. Now, same way, you can obtain the value for x of 5, x of 3, that means taking n equals to 3 or 5 as well, according to the question asked. It may happen that you will be asked for each and every instant, that means for n equals to 0, capital N equals to 0 to 5. Let's say for example, 5 point DFT sequence is there. You need to find all of the sequences, that means for x of 1, 2, 3, 4, likewise, by taking k equals to these values. Alright, we will see more examples in the further sessions. We will see the properties of DFT in upcoming sessions. So, I hope this example is clear to you now. These are the references. Thank you. Thank you for listening.